Hey, it's Rustomac, and this is how you download Portable Python. What you first want to do is go to portablepython.com, and this takes you to Portable Python's official webpage. Go down to Quick Links, under Quick Links, click on Download, and you want to download 2.5.4. The reason is that is because it's the most stable and it's the most tested, and also because I like to use this one in most of my videos. Either of these two should work fine, but I just download this one because it's the most tested. Next it takes you to another page which tells you exactly what you're downloading. It comes with I think 4 applications and numerous libraries. It comes with SPE, which is what I like to use, and PyScripter, which is also another highly rated Python environment. And it comes with a lot of libraries, the most important one being VPython. To download, click on any of these, preferably the USA one. You'll probably get the fastest speeds off of that. Portable Python is 64 megabytes, so depending on how fast your internet speed is, it might take a while. Once it's downloaded, actually I already have mine downloaded, so I'm gonna go ahead and cancel this. Once it's downloaded, you will find it wherever in your folder, wherever you saved it. It's gonna be saved as an executable file, so you can just go ahead and run this. The first question it's gonna ask you is where you wanna save it, and you can either save it straight onto your computer or onto your flash drive. And I like to save it onto my flash drive because that's what it was meant to do. And so you can just download it straight onto your flash drive or make another folder. Help you guys determine it. This is the folder that it's going to automatically make for you. So what I like to do is just save it straight onto my flash drive. So I have it right there. That's all I have. And under this, under the folder that they give to you, you get SPE, you get all these other ones, PyScripter, and under here you got all your libraries, DLLs, scripts, library, yeah. So once you get that downloaded, which will take a while, you can open up SPE just by clicking on here, and SPE also may take a while to open up, and here's SPE. Some things that are nice to modify is go to Edit, Preferences, and then go to Editor, font and size. I like to mess with that because the default one wasn't very good, so you can do that. Yeah, there's some other things. I'm not actually sure if the default came up with line numbers, but I also like to use that a lot. Here's your shell, just like what you, if you ever use just a regular idle. Here's outputs tab down here. Another nice thing is you can open up more than one file and have it tabbed. That's really nice. To run a program, just simply go up to Tools, go to Run Without Arguments, or just Run Stop Control R. I like to, normally I don't have arguments in my program, so I just do Control Shift R or just Control R for if you do have arguments. And that's about it. PyScripter runs about the same way that SPE does. So either of those two work. It's just my preference to use SPE. So there you go. That's how you download Portable Python, which includes everything you need to start programming. So thanks for watching. And if you ever want to figure out how to use Python, just watch my other videos and I show you how to start from the basics and work your way up from there. So thanks for watching.